Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to mix the paint stroke brushes in Photoshop and the double exposure technique to create this really cool paint stroke double exposure effect or a poster using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, please make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. All right, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I will go to File, New, and I will change this to 2500 and 1500 for the width. I will keep the resolution set to 72 and I will press OK. Alright, now I want to add a gradient, so I will go to Adjustment and choose Gradient. Then I will open the gradients in here, and as you can see we have different folder. So let's go with the gray. And let's choose something, yeah, like this one that we have a little bit dark with soft gray. And I will change the style to radio. Maybe the scanning, I will put it around 150. I think this is fine, and I hope it's okay. And let's delete this one in here and this one. All right, now we'll go and add a texture that I will make sure to upload for you guys so you can download it and follow along if you want. Alright, now I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to soft light and maybe drop down the opacity a little bit. Alright, now we have our background. Now we'll go and open the image I will be using for this. So I will open it in a new tab. Now as you can see, this image, it would be very easy to make a selection to because we have a clear separation between the background and the model. So I will go to select and choose subject, and then I will go back to select, and this time I will choose select and mask, and I will just mess with the smoothing. I will put 10 and I hope it's okay. All right, now I'm gonna one click on the layer mask, and this will apply it as a layer mask, but I don't think I need to use this with the layer mask, so I'm just gonna right click and apply this layer mask on the image. And then with the move tool, I will take it to the main tab in here and close this. All right, now I'm going to press Ctrl Command T, and I will make the model smaller, just like this. Yeah, maybe around here. All right, let's call this model. All right, next, I want actually to not use the same clothing in here. I want to use instead the stroke brushes that I show you in the beginning, that we have like the stroke coming from the clothes in here. And to do that, we're gonna apply a layer mask, or actually a black layer mask, by pressing Alt or Option on my keyboard while I'm holding Option or Alt. I will one click on the layer mask and it will apply a black layer mask. Now we can't see anything, so now we need to actually double click on the layer mask and put down the density of the layer mask for this to allow us to see where exactly we're gonna brush. So while I'm selecting the layer mask, make sure that you have the default background and foreground. If you don't have them, just press D on your keyboard and this will switch in the default. Now because we have black layer mask, we need to have white for us to reveal. So let's go actually to the brushes, and as you can see, I have in here 6 stroke brushes that you will find them down too in the description below. You can download them. So let's start with this brush in here. I will right click and rotate the brush because I want this tip to be down like that, and again using white as my foreground color, and have 100% opacity, 100% flow. And also I'm on the layer mask, not the layer itself, on the layer mask. I will go, for example, in this area, and I will one click like that. And maybe another click on top. And now I will change the brush to do something like this. And again, I will rotate it. And again, one click like that. And I will keep doing the same. All right, so once you are happy with your brushing, you can just double click again on the layer mask and make it 100%. And as you can see, this is what we have. Now, another thing that I forgot to mention, when you are using the brush, if you switch between black and white, you can delete and add. For example, I have here black as my foreground color, which means now I can delete from this part in here. Yeah, let's keep it like that. All right, so, and the same goes if you want to add, you can switch between white and then you can add in here. Let's actually add a little bit from this part too. All right, now I want actually to have a little bit of this stroke brush go a little bit outside from the model. And to do that, we're gonna make another copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl Command J. And then I will delete this layer mask. And now we have the complete body. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T and I will go up in here and put it up just like that. All right, now I'm gonna apply again another black layer mask by pressing Alt or Option and one click on the layer mask. And again, I will do the same. I will put down the density just like that. And using the same brush, I will go, for example, in this area and I will add a little bit just like that. And the same in here, maybe add a little bit in here. Yeah, something like this. Think this is enough. And let's put it down actually below the other layer. And again, I will go back and put the density to 100%. All right, now I want to reveal the head of the model. So I will go to this first layer and I will select the layer mask and let's rotate it. And let's actually try to connect everything together. Just like this. Yeah, so I would keep it like this. And of course, feel free to add as much as you want using these brushes. As you can see, it's pretty simple and easy to do. And you will have basically different results every time you do this. But for this tutorial, I think I will keep it like this. I think I'm happy with this. Now, I want actually to use this as a base for our double exposure. To do that, I need to merge the both of them. So before I'm gonna do that, actually I'm gonna make a copy of the two layers by selecting them both by pressing Ctrl and Ctrl to select this one. I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J. And while I'm having these two layers on top, I'll right click and choose Merge Layers. Now, we have one layer that it have the both two layers, if that makes sense. Let's actually group these two and let's call them original, just in case we want to go back and edit something. All right, so we're almost done. Now we only need to apply the image in here. So I will go and open the image I will be using of our war zone. So I will just make it smaller to fit. Maybe I will put down the opacity a little bit and see exactly where I want to put this. Maybe a little bit more in this side. Yeah, let's keep it like this. I think it looks really interesting. All right, now I'm gonna clip it to this layer in here. So while I'm selecting this, I'll right click and choose Create Clipping Mask, and this will clip it to this layer. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to, let's go for screen, and let's put the opacity 100%. And then I'm gonna apply a layer mask on this. It's a white layer mask, and I will go to my brushes. And this time let's go for a simple soft round brush, maybe with a lower flow. I will start deleting using black as my foreground color this time. I will delete like this. Yeah, maybe I will delete a little bit from here. Also from here. All right, so I think it looks really interesting. So, yeah. Okay, so we're almost done. Now the only thing I want to add is a little bit of adjustments. you can add as many adjustments as you want, but for me, I think I will keep it very simple. So I will go and choose gradient map, and let's change the gradient. For example, this color stop, I will change it to a darker blue, maybe something like that. And the black, I will change it to maybe, let's go for an orangey color. Maybe a little bit brighter than this. Or warmer than this. Yeah. And let's keep it like that. Maybe I would change the blue to be a little bit more stronger. All right. And let's put it a little bit in this area. Okay. All right, now I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to soft light, and then I'm gonna drop down the opacity to 0, and I will go up to see where it will look the best, maybe around 30. Yeah, I think it looks really cool. Now I want to add a little bit of light coming from these areas in here. So, and to do so, I will actually create a new layer, and let's call this light, and then using the gradient tool in here, and make sure that you have color to transparent in the basic folder. It's a color to transparent in here. Make sure that you are selecting it, and also the style is set to radial. Now by pressing alt or option, I can actually sample a color. For example, this one, I can sample it, and let's go, for example, in this area, I will one click and drag just like that. This will add this really cool light that is coming, let's say, from the neck area in here. And let's add one more, maybe this color in here. Let's add it in this spot, just like that. And maybe another small one in here, just like this. All right, now I'm gonna change the blending mode for this to screen or linear dodge. Let's keep it screen. And then put down the opacity a little bit to the range of 50%, and let's see before and after, and maybe a little bit more down. Yeah, I think it looks really cool. Now another thing that I want to add is a little bit of warmth. So to do that, I will go and actually maybe add a simple solid color. Let's keep it in the warm range like this. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to exclusion, and let's change the color even more. Let's see how it will react. Yeah, I like this, so I will keep it like that, and then I will drop down the opacity to 0, and I will go up to maybe 15%. I think it looks really cool, as you can see, maybe 12. Alright, so the last one that I want to add is another texture. So we'll go and open this texture in here. So we'll rotate it. And again, you will find this texture down in the link from the description below. You can download it. Alright, this one, I think I will change it to overlay, just to add a little bit of scratches to the whole thing. Yeah, I think it looks really cool. Now you can add as many things as you want. For example, you can add some birds in here. But for me, I think I really like it like this. Maybe I will go and add birds. Never know, but let's keep it like this for now. And that will be all. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this video, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.